allow Dr. TJ to say. Now we're going to go to your patient here.
Okay, so the left is obviously the before, and this is an early 40s Caucasian female. At this point, I've already done some fillers. I've already done a little bit of Voluma, a little bit of some Juvederm, a little bit of Sculptra, and she was kind of still looking tired and wanted to improve. Mainly was kind of like the sagging issue. So, Sheena, what kind of comments would you think that I possibly did on her?
So definitely, I think that trying to improve a little bit more the mid-face volume may help. Well, I don't know if that's what you did for the after picture, but it looks like her volume is much more natural. She looks a lot more useful, especially I like what you did around the perioral area. It looks much more improved, pre-jaw sulcus, all this stuff. So I'm thinking, and the quality of the skin looks a lot better, so I'm not sure if you did any light device or energy device to improve the quality of the skin, or of this is the effect of Sculptra. But overall, I think that was a great improvement on the mid-volume face. The shape of the face is more oval. To me, the best thing is what you did to the lower third of the face. I think it looks so much more useful and natural.
Dr. Kassir, being a surgeon, would you comment on this, and if you would offer her even a surgical option?
If that was a surgical result, I'd commend you on that too. So the fact that you did that non-surgically was pretty impressive. I agree with what Dr. Sheena Bay said. The lower third, you've done an excellent job. The philtrum to me looks, instead of built in where that line is really a crevice, it's flattened out a little bit and looks much more aesthetic. The mental crease looks better. The marionette lines look better. The jowls look better. And two areas that I see that look really, really good are the lower lid mid-face junction, especially on the right side. That's pulling away and almost looks like a festoon. I don't know how you corrected that, but it looks like volume and you did a nice job. I see she has platysmal bands on the left and none after, so you've either done neuromodulator or used some serious energy device to smooth that out. So again, whatever you did, very nice job.
Doctor, could you comment on what you would, how you would approach this patient?
Well, I think she got phenomenal results. She definitely looks much, much more improved. As Dr. Kassir said, the philtrum looks much more natural and her lips look better. The pre-jowl sulcus definitely has been volumized, and in that area, I would have used fillers. I basically tend to use either Sculptra or Radius in that area because it's just a much more robust filler for the jawline and chin augmentation. As far as the tear trough and under eye and where you have that malar defect that some people do get, it looks like you may have used a particular filler underneath. The first thing though that I would have done, and maybe you have done, is before even volumizing contouring, is my go-to is usually doing some radio frequency, microneedling high energy device for skin tightening for pores, used along with combination of PRP for the quality of the skin. If the patient needs laser resurfacing, then at that point I go ahead and do that. As far as any kind of lifting and volumizing, I will do that with the fillers. And I also do adjunctive therapy with the PDO threads in conjunction with that to get similar results.
Excellent. Yeah, at the time I didn't have the RF microneedling, but that's a great comment and great option. So it is combination therapy. And on the before picture, I already maxed out and she didn't want to continue stuffing more fillers. And so I gave her the option of threads. So what I did was, it's a very simple solution. I used the Mint PDO threads, which are the barb threads, 43 centimeters, attacked it with a stitch into the temporal fascia and tunneled it down to the lower third of the face, two on per side, and did basically a thread lift on her, which I didn't even address specifically the neck. That wasn't even toxins, that was just the result of the lift.
Great.
Just beautiful result. And one thing that I do PDO threads is being a learning curve for myself. I think that using threads, incorporating threads, is allowing us not to be so filler dependent. So I tell my patients that as the deeper tissue, especially the periosteum, is shrinking, you have two options. You either get fat, right, or put a lot of fillers, would that be three options. Or you bring your dress to the seamstress. So you use the thread. I use the analogy that we're using the thread. It's like taking your dress to the seamstress to be tailored to your new anatomy. And that always allows to take a few syringes of fillers out of the equation. Because I think that if we continue with especially HAs and you put HA between the bone and the muscle, then you're injecting HA in the muscle, then you inject HA intradermal, then you have this phase full of HA that I'm sure that when plastic surgeons here are trying to operate, that HA just pours out of the face like there's no tomorrow. So threats are actually, it's a game changer in the industry. Good job, TJ.
Very nice results. And I think that that is combination therapy, as Dr. Shinobe said, it minimizes the use of fillers. It does not negate the use of fillers. And as I tell my patients, especially because in Boca Raton, Florida, everyone either wants to look 20 years younger and they want no downtime. So a lot of people that don't want to undergo the knife or have surgery or undergo anesthesia and recovery time. So the other option would be then to combine the PDO threads and minimize the amount of fillers, but still they need the skincare, the lasers, and they will need the neuromodulators. So it is definitely combination therapy. Anyone else have any comments to add to that? No?
Dr. Buford, would you offer her a surgical option?
When I look at her face, basically two things scream out at me. Number one, improvement in skin quality, number two, volumization. So, you know, again, I would echo, this is a very good non-surgical result. I mean, I applaud you for this. You know, again, I get back to expectations because, you know, I have to imagine that for, you know, for every 10 that you do like this, you're not always going to get a home run like this. Obviously, I mean, and there's no offense to you. I mean, you know, I tell my patients the only thing that's predictable about tissue is the fact that it's unpredictable. You know, so we can you know, get these home runs, but then, you know, we don't always accomplish that. So it's really telling them this is what we can do. But doing what you did, though, I think this result looks great. So I'd like to see how durable it is.
About a year. And the studies with the men threads done in Korea were, they're all done at 12 months, and they had like 80 something percent satisfaction rate. So. Right.